Hey guys, we were just, I was about to boot up a game of Legend of Zelda, and you guys have never seen it, so I'm just going to show you guys it. So, if the graphics are not that great, that's because this is my first time doing it like this, so next time the graphics will look better. Like, a lot better. So today, what I'm thinking is that I'm going to show you guys what the DLC things do, or at least the ones that I've gotten. So, first things first, what I've gotten is the Phantom Armor. And this gives you attack up, and I'm going to go find an enemy to show you guys. And I can't seem to find an enemy anywhere. So, I guess let's go to the Great Plateau or Colosseum. Which brings me to, well, you guys know where the attack up is, right? It's pretty much the same thing as the Fierce Deity armor and the Barbarian. So this is really good. It has a defense of 26, and that's all. And this is what it looks like. The second one I want to show you is the what is it called? Majora's Mask. And how this one works is pretty crazy. Well, look, an enemy just showed up. So what Majora's Mask does is it blends in with enemies. The only enemies it doesn't blend in with is Honixes, Yuga Clan members, and I think that's all, but it blends in with all the other enemies, so. Oh yeah, and these. And those two too. And I just saw a star fragment fall, so if you guys want to go get that, we can. Oh. Look who we have here. I guess this is a good time to show you the Phantom Armor. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably use this, the Royal Broadsword, with combination of a Mighty Lino Bow and Shock Arrows. So, yeah, not that great. He kind of squished me with his hand, but that's fine. Let's just eat. Joy-Cons right now, so just so you know. So that's kind of how it works, I guess. It's
how the phantom armor works.
What should I get rid of, though? I should just get rid of that. So, I have not 100% completed the game yet. So, if you do want to see more episodes, I just want to get this video to one view. Just one view, at least. That's all. That's a Kona. And of course, the Guardian. We got it, guys. Which I'm very happy about. It looks exactly like a Kona, I think. I don't have any of the amiibos yet, so I can't really show you that, but I do have all the towers, and we're going to head to that star fragment. I do have Minna's helmet, which I'm going to show you next, because I'm really close to Guardians right now, so. I mean, this helmet will be really helpful if you don't like those guys, which I don't. They're so annoying.
Your Polly's Gale is now ready.
They like shoot you with lasers wherever you go, and they can follow you sometimes. So I just don't like them. They're so annoying. I don't think anyone likes them though. But look what we have here. I think we have two star fragments now, which is really nice. So we are going to go find a garden. No, I don't want to mess with that one. That one can walk. Let's go mess with not that one. That one can also walk. So we are going to have to run to Central Tower so we can fight a guardian that does not, and I'm going to repeat this again, that does not follow you. So just so you know, it's not going to follow us, but we're only going to use Minna's helmet and probably this sword that I have, the Royal Rock Sword, because it's a really good sword. There's a guardian. Okay. So that's how Minna's helmet works. It just makes guardians do a lot less damage to you, which I think is very helpful. And here's an air handy tip for you. Probably a lot of you already know this, but you get a bow and you see one of the skeleton guys, you shoot them in the head and it's an instant kill. So that's all. The next thing I wanted to show you is Majora's Mask, since I haven't been able to show you that yet. So we're going to probably go to the Colosseum right now to show you that it does work on Lynels. But I don't even know if there's a Lynel there. I might have already killed it. But I'll still show you how it works. So I'm just going to teleport over there. I think it's right there. So, I've done two Divine Beasts. If you guys want to see the other two, I can show you them. Okay? But, yeah, I kind of did two of them already. But that's up to you guys if you do want to see them anyway. And of course, right as we get here, the Master Sword's power has been restored, and we're not even going to fight a guardian. Because we already did. So, we're here just because it's close to the Colosseum. I'm not going to get a horse, but I am going to just run over there. And I think it's right there. If you guys don't know where the Colosseum is, it's right by Outskirts Stable. So, if you want to go there, there's a Lionel in the middle, so just fight him if you are prepared. But if you're like just leaving the Great Plateau, don't fight him because he might just kill you in one hit. And I learned that the hard way. Many times. So I'm going to put on Majora's Mask just so you do know that it works on Lionels. Because I only showed you it with one of the skeleton guys, so it doesn't only work on those skeletons. And right here, I don't know if you guys know this already, but pull out your Magnesis if you have the DLC, and there would be a chest right here with the Phantom Helmet in it. So. Now I'm gonna go up here to show you if there's any enemies in here. And no, there's not, because I cleared it. So. You better go find more enemies. There's some ruins over there. There's probably enemies. Oh, there's some enemies. That's where we'll go. Okay. So no, I am not doing any quest or anything right now, as you can see. I'm just kind of exploring. Because I think that's fun. I think that's why Ocarina of Time was so great, is because it was free roam. That was pretty much one of the first free roam games in the Zelda franchise. So as you can see, Majora's Mask just works like that. They don't attack you at all. And he has a nice broadsword. I thought that was royal, but it's not. Is there a chest in here? I don't know. There's not. But the bad thing about this is if you just attack one of them, they all attack you. So, it's just good, but I think it's good if you don't know where Skull Lake is, and if you can't find Kelton anywhere. Or if you sold all your monster cards and you can't afford any of them, you can just get this. So, the last thing I want, well, not the last thing, but I just want to tell you that I do not have all the armor sets for the DLC yet. So, if you guys want me to show you Tingle's outfit pretty soon, I think that's the only one I have left. Tingle's outfit and the Trial of the Sword, I can show you guys those. But today I'm just going to show you some techniques of fighting. Enemies. See, I had The reason they're not attacking me is because they didn't see that I attacked the other guys. But see, I attacked them. And now they're blowing their horns and trying to kill me now. And I'm about to die too, so I might as well just use the phantom armor and get attack up. And I think that's weird that, like, when he has, like, a mask on, he still eats. I'm just gonna grab this just because I kind of want to, and so no one else grabs it. I'm gonna get rid of it straight away anyways, but I think this guy's the last guy. I hear another one, I don't know where it is though. I think there's another sulfur one. Somewhere. It's lightning out. That guy's going to get struck, but I'm not. I'm taking off all my metal gear. And I'm just going to use this. And my shield's metal. He got struck by lightning. And that's the end of him. So, that's a good thing about this. I love the broadswords. They're like my favorite weapon in the whole game. But what's your favorite weapon in this game? Share your opinion in the comments. But mine's the broadsword. Or just any of the fast swords I mentioned. Climbor's second favorite, but I'm gonna go help these guys. Let me put on Majora's mask. But this is one of, I think, the best mask in the game. Salt grilled fish. Okay. I kind of do need more wooden weapons just because lightning happens a lot when I'm playing. I don't know why, but every time I play, it's either lightning or rain, something like that. Treasure. I think, is this Coral Ruins? If it is, this is where you get Majora's Mask. But Lake Coral Ruins is somewhere around here. No, it's not. Okay, yeah. Yeah, right there. That's where Majora's Mask is. Wooden bow? Can't carry any bows. Okay. Today I'm probably going to show you... Well, I want to get out of this lightning fast. So I'm just going to get out of here. So, As you can see, I have not gotten all 900 shrines, not even close. I think I've only gotten like 30 something, but that's all. I am going to go right to, oh, Snowy's over there. I'm gonna go probably to a stable and sell all my stuff that I got from those sulfur goblins. I got a sapphire, a ruby, another ruby, and topaz, I'm pretty sure. And I'm going to sell both of my star fragments that I got. I got one in this video, but I got one a little earlier, so I'm trying to find a stable. I've done 50 shrines. And it's lightning here. I just really don't like the lightning in this game. It's because you can't use metal
weapons.
Like, I would think that you could use metal weapons, like, if it wasn't lightning. Like, if you were indoors, but if you use a metal weapon and you're indoors, the lightning just strikes in this game. So we're just going to sell the star fragments. I know once I get the wild set and things like that, I'm going to save my star fragments. But for now, I'm just going to sell them. 600 rubies, that's how much you have to pay to get a 20 pack of bomb arrows. It's easier just to get whatever it's called. Just get two of the 10 pack bomb arrows, so it'd be cheaper. But I sell all my rubies. Okay. That's all that we're going to do here. And what else is I going to show you guys? I was going to show you guys the Trial of the Sword today. That's why he's right there. That's why I am going to show you the Trial of the Sword right now, but I might not complete it. I might just die straight away. Because I'm really bad at, like, even Tide Island. I tried to kill the Honix, but I died straight away because I had no armor. I only had, like, a tree branch and Boko spears trying to kill a blue Honix. So it was really hard. Then I got one-shotted by a moblin that had a soldier's broadsword. I'm just going to try to at least get to floor 7, because that's like the rest zone. The rest zone. But maybe I can even complete the beginning trials with you guys. Who knows? I'm just going to place the Master Sword in to get the Trial of the Sword. So what I did last time to get past this is I snuck over there and took their weapons. The only one I didn't take was a spear on accident. But I really want to get both of them. Look at the stick. So, it's really handy to get their weapons before. So get the axe, get the Boko club, and that's all. So that's what I did. It's probably a really good strategy. But oh, I don't have full health. This is bad. Gonna get my other tree branch. I got to at least level 5 on this, but I died after that. So, it's pretty bad. I am going to grab this. So we have a little bit of food. No, I'm just gonna salvage this place. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but I grab that shield. I think the next one you can get a traveler's sword in it. I'm pretty sure, but I don't know. So we're gonna get to the next floor right now. Sword is pretty hard, I think. You have to have that guy see you, that choo-choo. So he starts an updraft so you can get up there. I'm gonna take out this knife really quick. Pretty well, guys. Going really well for us. Oh, I'm so used to getting monster parts. Let's go to the next floor. I think that was floor 2. So this will be floor 3. Floor 3 is probably the hardest. There's a blue goblin with a soldier's broadsword. When you have like a traveler's sword and not that good on flurry rush. Oh no, this floor 4 is the hardest that I've done. but the next door ones are getting fired.